The stock market on track for its best start to a new year in over three decades. Here now is David Bahnsen, Chief Investment Officer of the Bahnsen Group at HighTower Advisors. So David, the S&P 500 up 8% almost so far this year. This seems to be way beyond what anyone was expecting. I mean, a whole year's worth of gains in 1 month.
Yes, and it usually bodes well in January when you start off that well for the remainder of the year as well. It's compounded this year by the fact that it wasn't like it was reversing from 2017. It was carrying momentum that had been there throughout all of last year as well.
Do we run up in the first half of the year? Does that momentum continue? But then perhaps the second half of 2018 is much different than the first?
I think that's very possible. More than likely, at some point, you have to have the Fed kind of take a little air out of it. Mm. Our belief is that you're not necessarily going to see a full risk on go to risk off, which has kind of been the market we've been in for about 10 years, and a lot more risk on than risk off. At periods where the market has sold off since the financial crisis, pretty much every risk asset is sold off. We think this is going to be different. Now you're going to see more rotational developments, maybe capital flowing into Europe or Japan or more emerging markets, moving from growth into value. So that's more likely what you'll see at some point later in the year.
So growth to value, perhaps that signals a more cautious attitude, though.
Or a valuation-sensitive attitude. You can call it cautious. We would call it prudent. We think it would be a very opportunistic investment theme.
The question of profit-taking comes into play when we've run up as much as we have. If you don't need the money in your investments anytime soon, should you book some profits right now?
From our vantage point as dividend growth people, we don't view it that way. We are looking for dividends to continue to grow, and the underlying asset price can always be trimmed from the vantage point of risk management, but we don't think that that people need to be out trying to actively trade it. In fact, people that have been doing so have definitely left a lot of money on the table. You want to be prudent and stick to a discipline.
We're seeing a surge in bond yields, the 10-year now at 2.71%. At what threshold does that level start to impact the case for owning equities?
Well, I'd be careful about anyone who gives a real confident answer to that question, because we don't have any idea. We haven't been there. The 10-year has been below these levels for so long that at what point the 10-year actually starts to pressure, from a discount rate standpoint, the compelling case for risk assets, particularly equities, we don't know. I think it goes right through 2.75. Maybe 3% becomes a bit of resistance. It's more about the Fed balance sheet, in my opinion, than it is the 10-year itself.
All right, David, you're also the author of the new book, Crisis of Responsibility. Give us a brief overview of what you're talking about here.
It's essentially an overview of the different things that have left some in our economy and in our society disgruntled, and suggesting that more than looking to a particular policy prescription, the left has the folks that they want to blame, the right has the folks they want to blame, suggesting that what is needed is from Main Street a resurgence of individual responsibility, a sort of remoralization of the culture.
All right, owning your future.
That's right.
All right, David Bahnsen, thank you so much for coming back.
Great to be with you.